Welcome everyone to my channel. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board certified OBGYN. And today we're talking about, can you get pregnant when you are not ovulating? So in this video today, we will review ovulation in detail. We will break down the menstrual cycle so that you understand the changes that occurs as you go from month to month. We will talk about sperm, how long it survives inside of your system and much more. And at which point in your cycle are you most fertile? Let's jump into it. Ovulation is the process of pulling an egg from your reserves. And by your reserves, what I'm referring to is as a female, when you are born, you have all the eggs you will have for a lifetime. You're not making a new egg each month as you ovulate. You're actually just pulling an egg from your stores. You're maturing it, you're allowing it to grow, and once it's matured all the way, your body will then release this egg into your fallopian tubes. So let's take a look at what that looks like. So on this side, I'm going to draw what your uterus kind of sort of looks like. This is my version, okay? My artistic version. All right, so this is your uterus. You have one. The purpose of your uterus is either to have a period or to get pregnant or carry a pregnancy. The bottom portion of your uterus is the cervix. Surrounding that is your vagina. Connected to your uterus is two fallopian tubes, which are very, very, very important because this is where fertilization occurs. On the sides here, we have two ovaries. And these ovaries house all the eggs you'll have for a lifetime. So when ovulation occurs, your body picks one of these eggs, matures it, releases this egg into midair. And the cool part about anatomy is that the fingertips or the ends of your fallopian tubes will literally grab this egg and will possess it, will hold it, and will bring it to the center of your fallopian tube, waiting for sperm to arrive and for fertilization to happen right in that area. That is the process of ovulation. Now, eggs survive inside of the fallopian tube for about 24 hours in total. So whenever we think of the menstrual cycle, which really is the beginning of one period, to the beginning of the next period. And you'll count all the days in between both starts of your cycles to get your menstrual cycle length. On average, that would be somewhere between 21 and 35 days. With that, we know that 14 days before the next cycle, this process of ovulation occurs. And so there's really only a 24-hour period of time between your menstrual cycles that you can actually get pregnant. So if no sperm is actually in your system waiting for this egg to arrive, the egg after 24 hours will die. Once the death of that egg happens, the uterus then says, okay, we did not get pregnant, let's have a period. And so 2 weeks later or 14 days later, you'll have a menstrual cycle. If there is a sperm there and fertilization occurs, so I'm gonna draw my sperm, if you can see it. If the sperm meets the egg, fertilization occurs, they travel together to the uterus, and instead of you having a period, pregnancy is established because your uterus is either doing one of two things, pregnancy or a period, unless you're in menopause. Now, it's very important that we understand that we are not able to get pregnant if no ovulation occurs, because ovulation is the release of that egg. If your eggs are trapped inside of your ovaries, there's no fertilization, there's no pregnancy, it will not happen. There are conditions that specifically may affect whether or not your eggs are being released on a monthly or regular cycle. That is called PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome. In PCOS, oftentimes the eggs are trapped inside of the ovaries, and even though your body is really wanting to ovulate and to release the eggs never mature all the way. And so they get stuck. And so when we do an ultrasound and we take a look at your ovaries, literally what we see are like lots of eggs midway in their maturity, trying to ovulate, trying to mature all the way. But because of hormonal imbalances, they stop their growth and they're stuck inside of the ovaries. And so what we also find is that in patients with PCOS, their ovaries grow and they're actually a little bit bigger. And so they might be as big as this because they're filled with so many immature eggs that are being stuck in their maturation process and not able to be released. And if they're not being released, there's no pregnancy. The same may happen if you're under chemotherapy or radiation treatment, or if you're on medications that will stop the ovulation process. So many things can affect how your eggs and your ovaries are functioning. You could have thyroid disorders, very common, so many different things. And so ovulation is necessary for you to be able to get pregnant. Next, it's also really important that we understand the menstrual cycle and how hormones help with our ovulation. So let's take a look at that. Let's make this the first day of your menstrual cycle. This will be the first day of your next menstrual cycle on a 28-day cycle, okay? So 28 minus 14 would be 14. So right around day 14 of a person with a 28-day cycle, you will ovulate. So ovulation would be right here. Inside of your body, we have this happening actually inside of your uterus, to be specific. When you have a period, your tissue on the inside of the uterus here bleeds off and the tissue becomes thin. And then as your period ends and you start building up new hormones, more estrogens, the inside part of your uterus will continue to get thicker and build up. So it grows and grows and grows. When the egg dies, which is somewhere around here, your body says, hey, we need to reverse this. We need to remove all the tissue we've been building up waiting for a pregnancy because it's not happening this month. And so that's very important. Now, how does that look for someone who has a longer cycle? Let's make this an extension. And let's do 35 days. If your cycle length from first period, first day of the last period to the first day to the next one is 35 days, for you to know when you're going to ovulate, you want to subtract 14 from 35, which would be 21. And that's the day of your cycle where you have ovulation, which means you have a longer period of time before ovulation on this end. But what's the same always is the 14 days before your cycle when ovulation occurs. The same thing would happen if you have a shorter cycle. Now, understanding this concept is imperative to understanding whether or not you can get pregnant based on whether or not you're having periods and if you're ovulating. And so it becomes easy once we understand these normal concepts. I hope this has been great understanding for you. Listen, I want you to get something special today. As we're talking about hormones, balancing them, and helping our bodies function well, I want to add and give you a gift, which is a free copy of my ebook, Hormones Don't Lie. And you can get that today by clicking the link below this video, wherein it will take you to my website. I'll send the ebook copy over to your email and you'll be able to start that today and learn so much more about your body and what happens here. And with so many more hormones in our bodies, we'll break it all down for you. I'm Dr. Perkins. Thank you for being with me. Thank you for watching today. And if you like what we've been talking about, you can leave a comment below, subscribe, share with someone who needs to know this stuff. That way, we can all be stronger together. Thank you for being here again, and we'll see you next time.